So today we're gonna go try to catch a swordfish.
Sam Milazzo is an awesome dude, man. I really like going out with him. He's very knowledgeable at what he does.
Good call, Sam. Saw that frigate from a mile away.
Sam had mentioned, you know, if we spend enough time on the swordfish, we will probably catch one. He said, but we have to kind of determine if we run across some dolphin, are we gonna stop?
Sam!
We're in them.
I'm going tuna fishing with you more often.
Yeah, buddy. Tuna fishing's great.
Sword fishing's good, too.
But we definitely have one on?
We definitely have a sword on.
Oh! Yeah! Come on, come on. Oh! He ate it. He ate it. He ate it. Nice, baby. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
I thought you said you had
to... Look at him. Relax.
Oh! Dude, relax. He just ripped my boat off. Oh! Awesome. Look at that big boy. Woo!
K Saltwater Experience, presented by Yellowfin, with Captain Tom Rowland and Captain Rich Tudor.
So, what do you think? We got some bait? What do you think we can catch with it?
Well, this time of year is like a transition time of year. You know, you got the summertime fish are on the way out. You got the wintertime fish that are starting to show up. So it can be a really exciting time of year if you get your summertime fish that are kind of lagging behind, which is sort of what we got now. There's still a few dolphin around.
Yeah.
But there is some tunas on the hump, blackfin tunas. And unfortunately, there's a lot of sharks mm-hmm. there with the tunas.
Yeah.
So it can be exciting, but very tricky to get dinner home. And we try not to feed.
Yeah.
You know, if the sharks are real bad, try not to feed a lot of tunas to them.
Yeah, no doubt. So tunas, dolphins, swordfish, anything. That sounds great.
Sam Milazzo is an awesome dude, man. I really like going out with him. He's a very professional guide, very cool demeanor, and obviously very knowledgeable at what he does.
Yeah, it was good. We went up and met him in Key Largo this time. You know, fishing out of there's all kinds of different opportunities. The bait catching up there has been really good, and he had a spot dialed in where he wanted to catch these cigar minnows. That's a really cool bait, and just put us in perfect position to have all kinds of options.
Yeah, I like going out of Key Largo because, you know, most of my time in the Florida Keys is spent on the other end of the Florida Keys. Florida Keys is 150 miles long. Key Largo is the northernmost portion of the Florida Keys. Key West would be the southernmost or the westernmost portion of the Florida Keys. And it's known for a lot of different things. You know, you've got John Pennycamp Park up there, which is a phenomenal snorkeling and diving location. Key Largo is known for its proximity to the Everglades National Park, but it's cool for me to go up there and get all the way up there and just experiencing the fishing. Sam obviously knows it really well. Get out to the bait spot, catch the bait, and he was ready to go. He wanted to spend as much time as he could at the swordfish grounds, and felt like if we spent enough time sword fishing that we would catch one.
90% chance, he said. I was like, dang, that's a pretty good chance. Like, all right, that gave me some confidence. But he's just dialed in, man. He's a fishy guy, you know, gets out there. You know, we tried the tunas for a little bit, got them popping, hooked three or four of them, you know, had some great bites, had this new reel from Daiwa, which was cool, that free swimmer. Which was kind of nice because you put a live bait out there, put it into that free swimmer mode, and just put it in the rod holder, and it's almost like having the bail open. It's going out nice and easy with no resistance. Pick the rod up, you know, real tight, and you got the fish on.
Yep, there he is. That's pretty cool. Look at him busting. Oh, yeah. Man. Jumping out of the water.
Oh.
That's slick.
Well, I like that you don't have to flip the bail.
Unfortunately, the tunas, man, we hooked them, but the sharks were bad. Even fighting them as fast as we could, the sharks were getting them.
Ah, oh,
so close. Yeah, it's not easy, that's for sure. Yep.
Sharks are relentless, man.
I thought I had him.
Say we pull back up and we'll try it one more time, and then if not, we'll see if we can catch a sword. Maybe we'll see some dolphin on the way.
He was talking about this time of the year, and he was saying, you know, that this is kind of a transition time of the year, the fall, that you have your summer fish, talking about dolphin and mostly, that the summer fish are kind of leaving, and the winter fish, the sailfish mostly, are kind of showing up. And you can get in this transition period to where you see both of them. And he was kind of hoping for that. But he said, we have to kind of determine if we run across some dolphin, are we gonna stop? We were like, of course we're gonna stop. I mean, why would you not stop on a nice school of dolphin?
My favorite fish, man. I got a bite.
You on?
There he is.
All right, take your time. Let's see if we can catch a couple more here.
Nice one. All
right.
Yep, just take your time. Oh, see if you hook some more.
Good call, Sam. Saw that frigate from a mile away.
He just has read those birds so many times. He's watching that warbird coming down. He's seen his, like, that one's on him. And sure enough, man, we got over there. So we just put a little ballyhoo on there, just head hooked him. Nothing fancy on a spinning rod. And you know, it was really cool because we ended up having three warbirds circling right over our baits as we came through there. You know, you just knew it was going to happen.
All right, double header.
See if we can get a triple.
Look at the frigates coming down too, that's great.
Boy, it did happen, and the strategy was, you know, let's put a couple of ballyhoo out there and just skip those along as we kind of are coming under these birds, and sure enough, we got bit right away. You had one on. Sam hooks up another one, and we bring the school right to us.
Are we close?
Yeah, he's ready for you whenever you want.
All right. Here, you want to finish this one off?
I'll finish it off.
Appreciate it. My arms are getting tired anyways.
Thanks,
I got
man.
A bad rotator.
I always like it when my dad hooked the fish for me.
All right, I'll bring them right up here and you can grab them. Nice. Well done,
beautiful.
Dude.
They are pretty.
That's what I like about fishing with you. You always tell us we're going to fish for one thing, and we always find dolphin.
Well, that's you got to be prepared, you know, because especially when you get offshore, you never know.
Well, that's one of my favorite, absolute favorite things in the world.
I'm bringing the open ready for you.
All right, right in the box. Over the rail and in the pail. He's on there.
You think that's him?
Yeah, we're tight.
But we definitely have one on?
We definitely have a sword on.
That's awesome.
Right on.
The Hawks K Saltwater Experience, presented by Yellowfin, is brought to you by Hawks K, find what lures you. Lowrance, America's number one fish finder. Waypoint, the destination for outdoor entertainment. Mercury Marine, go boldly. St. Croix Rods, the best rods on earth. Marathon, in the Florida Keys. And by Ameritrail Trailers, Daiwa, Black Rifle Coffee Company, Power Pole, and Reflex Boat Decking.
Sam had mentioned, you know, if we spend enough time on the swordfish, we will probably catch one, he said. But, you know, the dolphin fishing can be pretty good. And, you know, the idea was we're going to, you know, go out there and catch what we catch. But, you know, even if it's a giant school, probably move on from the dolphin to move to the swordfish. So all he was looking for, he's like, all we need to see is a warbird. Sure enough, we see a bird. He runs over there and he's like, this is exactly what we're looking for.
And one day I'm gonna actually go dolphin fishing with you, all right? Because every time we always go, we always find dolphin.
Well, that's the second time we've been tuna fishing and caught dolphins.
That's right.
All right, Sam, we're about ready here. It's a good fish here.
Oh, yeah, there he is.
Come on. Hello.
See that one?
Seems like you've done that before.
Yeah, that is a little bull, huh?
You know, the dolphin is a fish that anybody would like getting into a school of dolphin. They're beautiful, they're colorful, they jump. They're really, once you get the school up there, they're not hard to catch at all, and just tons of action. And then when you get them in, the dolphin is one of the best fish on the table. It's just a fantastic fish all around.
Ha, this is as good as any spring dolphin day I've seen them.
Oh, yeah.
These look a little smaller, maybe.
That's all right, they're keepers. I'm hungry.
Yeah,
I'm hungry too.
We got him on the circle hook.
Sam!
We're in him.
I'm going tuna fishing with you more often.
Yeah, buddy. How do you like tuna fishing? Tuna fishing's great.
Sword fishing's good, too.
Nice little bull here.
Dolphin fishing is always so exciting, man.
Yeah.
Like, coming from the inshore, where we're like five fish in a day would be amazing.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes you can get into them. There's hundreds of them there. This was a decent-sized school, and, you know, almost every rod that we have in the boat has a fish on it. So that was fantastic. We have four or five, you know, Sam starts gaffing the fish, putting them in the box because they are going to be a fantastic dinner.
That's sweet.
Buddy, nice job.
Wow.
Hey, that one's right on there, man.
I got to make some room in the cooler for him.
I mean, it's all right, you know, if you're into really nice fish.
Dolphin fishing. Too bad we're tuna fishing today.
Yeah.
Sam put us in the meat, had a cooler full of mahi, and it's time to go look for that swordfish.
That's awesome, Sam.
Nice job,
it is. Good job, Sam.
Box full of dolphin.
Yeah, man.
You tell us we're going to
the eagle. I like it. Yeah. Birds.
But that's the thing about fishing, you know, you gotta go. You never know.
Never know, you gotta go. Fishing.
Yep, there's more.
Could be a t-shirt.
Yeah.
We did go sword fishing together probably 15 years ago when this daytime sword fishing was just starting to, you know, be noticed and popular. And then we were using squid, and it was just, the techniques were similar but so much different. It has gotten so refined over the last 15 years, and Sam's been at the cutting edge of that and watching how he was rigging this swordfish bait, you know, and using a dolphin belly. And, you know, it was really interesting just to see the technique.
You always want to drop with the current. You go the same direction as the current. All right, you ready?
Yeah.
Put it in gear.
I'm going straight to the number.
Here we go. Let's try it.
Just barely in gear?
Nope. You got to throttle up a little bit. I want to go right towards the number. A little throttle.
How long will it take to hit the bottom?
5 minutes.
5 minutes.
Like that, yep.
How heavy is the weight you use?
10 pounds.
10 pounds. Takes 5 minutes to hit the bottom.
Yep.
Good speed for you?
And we're going right towards the number?
Yes, sir.
Okay, perfect.
Sam was coaching us on how to drive the boat, because the technique is basically don't get tangled. That's a really, really important thing, because if you were to get tangled, it's so far down there, it took you 5 minutes to hit the bottom, and then you're gonna make a 30 or 40 minute drift probably. You're only gonna be able to do that so often. So he had a real technique that he had figured out. You know, and I was asking him, I was like, how long did it take you to figure out how to put this in the water like that? He said, first time. And then he laughed and he's like, no, man, it wasn't the first time. It took 10 years to figure this out. So we're out there with a guy that's worked these details out. And that's really what it is about, you know, great fishermen. They've had more time to make more mistakes, and then they've learned from those mistakes and they've applied what they've learned. That's the way that you become a great fisherman, and that's what Sam's been able to do. And we saw it firsthand.
Let's go swordfish.
Let's go swordfish.
We don't want a real big one, just like maybe, you know, 250, 300, something manageable.
Oh, we did this years ago, man, when it was just starting to get popular. And I was amazed, man, first drop we caught one. But yeah, man, it's amazing how you guys have perfected it over the years.
I mean, for me, I just messed it up enough times to kind of slowly learn how to sometimes make it happen.
We were really excited because we had this new reel from Daiwa, the Tanacom, and the big deal about this reel is that it's the first reel that can handle a swordfish that's under $1,000. And these reels, they're electric reels, and they are very, very expensive. And so it precludes a lot of people from getting out and experiencing sword fishing because the gear is just too expensive. And so when Daiwa comes out with this reel that is affordable and you can get out there and be able to do this with a reel that's under $1,000, it's gonna open it up to a lot more people to be able to experience what we just did.
Boy, it'd be so cool to catch one.
Yeah, I mean, I think we got a good shot. We got a bait down there and we're in a good spot. And basically when you're sword fishing, you're, you know, anywhere from 1,400 to 1,800 feet, maybe a little deeper in some areas for some people, but it's basically a ledge. It's like the reef. It's very similar to the reef. Deeper water, steeper ledge, bigger fish usually.
Yeah. Yeah. So I've been using this new Daiwa Free Swimmer Reel. It's been a great option for us. It really answers one of the biggest problems we have in fishing. Whether we're offshore or inshore, we're always trying to, you know, leave the bail open so the fish can eat a bait, whether it's a live bait or a dead bait or something. We want them to be able to eat it and swim away without feeling any resistance so we can swallow that bait before we set the hook. And traditionally, we would have to have the bail open like this, maybe keep the line on a piece of wire or something like that so the fish can swim off easy. And then we have to close the bail by hand and then reel. And it's kind of an awkward thing and really some problems with that. Daiwa's Free Swimmer comes out with this secondary drag setup here where we engage this free swimmer and we can make it tighter or looser.
And so that drag is barely engaged, right? So that fish can, now you can have your live bait out there, your dead bait, the fish can pick it up and just start swimming slowly, feeling no resistance whatsoever until you're ready to set the hook. Once you feel like he's got it down there good and I'm ready to set it, all I have to do at that point is just turn the handle and it engages. And now we're on to the regular drag, the hard drag. The hook set, we're fighting the fish. It's really a cool setup, very smooth. And this is really gonna be great for everything from tarpon fishing, sailfish offshore, all kinds of applications where we want that bait to be able to swim freely. And we want the fish to be able to grab it, swim away without feeling any resistance. This Daiwa Free Swimmer is a great option for us.
The Hawks K Saltwater Experience, presented by Yellowfin, is brought to you by Yellowfin. Live deeper. Hook. Tackle Direct, the world's premier fishing outfitter. Yeti, built for the wild. Key Largo, in the Florida Keys. And by Golden Boat Lifts. Power Pole Move. Nikon. And Lithium Pros.
Did you know you can get every episode of Saltwater Experience completely free on Waypoint TV? Go to waypointtv.com and find out how you can download the app or find it on any smart TV. And if that's not enough, you can find the Tom Rowland Podcast on Apple, Spotify, or anywhere you find podcasts. And we'd love to have you as a follower on Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube.
Let's catch something this time.
You just hit the bottom. You were, and it's 1850.
1850, so I was you're, 50 off. That's close.
Really close.
We get down there on the bottom, and now we're sword fishing. It's just like other kind of fishing, except you're actually trolling on the bottom. So you're trolling in 1500, 1700, 2000 feet of water. So there's nothing visual that you're seeing. You're just watching that rod tip. And what you're watching for is, he was saying that that rod tip is gonna have a certain cadence. And that rod tip is just gonna all of a sudden go out of that rhythm. And that's all you're looking for. And we were all kind of watching that at one point. And it was just enough to where that was just out of rhythm.
It was obvious once we finally got the bite. There was lots of waiting, lots of patience. He even said, all right, well, 30 more minutes and we'll head back, And it was kind of like, all right, well, I guess it didn't happen today, whatever. And I see this rod, boom, that was a bite. It was obvious.
I think he's on there.
You think that's him?
Yeah, we're tight. Just pulled him off, maybe. Oh, he's there. I don't think it's a real big one.
But we definitely have one on?
We definitely have a sword on.
That's awesome.
Right on.
Dude, I did see that bite clear as day. That was a pretty good bite.
See the rod tip, he's on there. I don't think it's a real big one, but hopefully he's a keeper. He can just kind of angle this way.
This is a brand new thing with this reel, the Tanacom. Nobody has ever caught a swordfish on the Tanacom before, and we were the first ones. We get one of the first reels out there, and that thing performed flawlessly. If the fish is pulling drag, it can pull drag. If there's any slack in the line or anything, it will pull it in, but it's performing just as if we're reeling that in.
I got a lot of heat on them.
Yes. This is awesome. That's freaking amazing, dude. That reel's doing good, huh?
No, I love this reel, actually. I mean, it's the first time I ever use it. The rod tip's in the water, so that's a good indication that it's a good one.
As the fish is coming up and we're at like probably 400 or 500 feet from us, you were on the controls on the boat, I got on the controls on the rod, Sam's got the harpoon ready. I mean, this is gonna be a team effort.
Yes.
All right,
it's getting exciting
go
now.
Again.
Still here?
Yeah, you're good right now, yep. And you might have to start turning, if he goes,
yes.
If the angle of the line's here, you want to turn to the left and it'll get the motors, it'll swing the motors away.
number one job was getting the fish up. Well, that was an effort because that fish was fighting. Sometimes he came up, sometimes he took the line out. Sam, at one point, it was kind of a stalemate, and Sam's, you know, kind of easing the line up, which I thought was a good technique, using your fingers just to help the reel along, not try to overpower it with the reel itself. And then finally, once it got up, you know, in that 100 foot, the anticipation of what's there, what do we have, kept building and building and building until, you know, finally, all right, zero. Yep, I see him.
See him right here.
I see a fishy. Wow, look at that thing.
Let's go, Sam.
That is so cool, man.
Easy. Get him? Got him.
Got him?
Yeah, get the gaff, 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 gaff. Right in the head. Right in the head. There you go.
Yeah, baby! Woo! How about that?
Foul hook. Get another gaff, another gaff.
Wow. That is incredible, man.
Foul hook. That's why he fought so hard.
Wow, that is awesome, dude.
We got dinner, baby.
That is cool, hey, dude. Nice job, man.
Dude, I thought he was going to be a lot bigger because he's...
Dude, he's awesome. Wow.
That is amazing, man.
You know, the coolest thing about that swordfish when I saw it is just the purple on the back, the incredible color you just don't see in any other fish. And then the eyeball, you know, you see the pictures and you see this, but you know, when you see that eyeball looking at you, I mean, just a crazy looking animal. The bill itself is, you know, just longer than you'd think, disproportionately long for its body compared to any other billfish.
There you go.
That is sweet.
You guys got it?
I think so. That's freaking awesome, huh? That's nice, dude.
Good job, boys.
That was right fun. On.
Wow.
One for dinner.
I just think it's so cool that you could go out to the middle of the ocean with one hook and drop down to the bottom of the ocean and actually have a chance of catching that. We're going sword fishing, we're going here, we're gonna drop one bait down and we're gonna catch one. That's what Sam said, and that's exactly what we did.
Well, you're confident, man.
That was like,
it's amazing.
Yeah.
That was like killing an elk or something. I mean, dang, man. All of a sudden.
Got my heart going. Well, I really thought that fish was gonna be over a couple hundred pounds. That's usually how the bigger ones act, but.
Strong.
Really, really cool.
All right, let's clean up. We'll get out of here. Get that guy on some ice.